Straight out of Norfolk, Matt Coleman is representing my hometown, the 757, where we're known for breeding top-notch athletes such as Allen Iverson, Michael Vick, Alonzo Mourning, Percy Harvin, Justin Upton, Cat Barber, Troy Williams, and the list goes on. So when I saw Matt Coleman as an 8th grader, I knew right away that he had the potential to join the club, and I've had the privilege of witnessing him go from a local star at Maury High School to Oak Hill as one of the best guards in the country. And now he'll take his talents to Shaka Smart in the Texas Longhorns. I believe point guards and quarterbacks are born. They're not made. It's something inside of them that allows them to lead others in the heat of battle. And it's something that Matt has had in him since the first time I saw him. He was able to lead Maury as a sophomore. He led Boo Williams in the EYBL, and he led Oak Hill to a national championship. He's constantly communicating with his teammates, and he's an extension of the coaching staff on the floor. Matt has great speed in the open floor, and he's a phenomenal passer off the dribble. So when you put those two together, it makes for a high-octane offense that puts pressure on the defense every time a shot goes up. His teammates run the floor hard because they know he'll find them, and it's something that every college coach in America is looking for. Watch as Matt catches the outlet and pushes the ball up the floor. He's going full speed, but he's under control and he's reading the defense, waiting for someone to commit, and then he reacts accordingly. All he needs is a small gap to get the ball where it needs to go. This level of accuracy takes time to develop. It's something you work on just as much as everything else. And once you get the hang of it, you can put on a show while making your teammates better. But keep in mind that it's not always necessary for a guard to push the ball off the dribble. The best point guards know when to push it and when to pitch it ahead. This is something Matt is very good at. If he sees an open teammate ahead, he can deliver the ball on time and on target. Much like a quarterback, this takes the right touch and the right placement to lead your man and hit him in stride, all while avoiding deflections. Now we'll look at his ability to hit cutters in the half court. This requires great vision, but it takes more than just seeing an open man. You've got to be able to react in a split second. Whether he's attacking the basket or working from the perimeter, he's always got his head up and is ready to deliver the pass. In order to do this at a high level, you've got to get your ball handling to a point where you can handle ball pressure while keeping your dribble alive and keeping your head up to survey the floor. Watch as Matt passes right off the dribble, and watch how quickly he reacts when help defense rotates to cut him off. These are all split-second decisions, and none of them are premeditated. You've got to read the defense on the fly. Last, let's look at his ability to facilitate off the drive. In order to do this, you've got to be able to break down your man, get into the paint, and force a defensive rotation. This is something Matt does naturally. His quickness allows him to get paint touches at will. On-ball defenders struggle to cut him off because he's constantly changing speeds and he has a great first step. Notice the speed at which he's doing this. The reason he looks so flashy is because he's mastered the art of reading defensive rotations. It's simply an ability to read and react, and that ability has made Matt one of the best facilitators in the country. It's clear by now that Matt is a pass-first point guard, but keep in mind that you can't facilitate at this level without the ability to score also. It keeps the defense guessing. And here we'll look at his ability to score in transition. We've already discussed his speed in the open floor, but now you're seeing it applied in a scoring role. Notice his ability to move at full speed while maneuvering into tight spaces. Also notice the way he changes speeds. Knowing when to coast and then burst into gaps is essential when looking for scoring opportunities. And when you get to your spot, you've got to be ready to embrace and finish through contact. You're witnessing great ball control, and I recommend getting ball handling reps, going full speed, changing directions at full speed, and using stutter steps and hesitations going full speed. As you can see, Matt has a number of moves that he uses in transition. From his double cross to his hezo to the ball fake and the in and out cross, Matt has a number of go-to moves that he uses to evade defenders and push it ahead. And once again, none of this is premeditated. You've got to read and react to the defense if you want to do this at a high level. In order to attack the basket in the half court, you've got to learn to read the second and third defenders. It's not every day that the lane opens up like this, and when it does, you see the result. But watch here as Matt spins off the second defender, and watch here as he splits the second defender. In both cases, the third defender was late on the rotation, allowing him to finish the layup. When on the wing, you've got to hunt for the open post, which is when the lane is vacated on your side. If you're athletic enough, this can result in easy dunks when the defense is slow on the rotation. In scenarios where the defense does rotate on time, you've got to make the decision on whether to finish around them or come to a jump stop and make a counter move. Matt has developed the ability to make all of these reads, and it allows him to finish at a high level in the paint. Now we'll look at one of the most effective moves to use on a second defender, the hezo. This allows you to freeze the defender, getting them on their heels and then bursting past them. When bigs come up the lane to help, this is the best way to blow by them. And last, when you're attacking baseline and the help rotates over, always keep the option available to use the rim in your favor. Reverse layups are a great way to counter rotating bigs when attacking baseline. So far, everything we've looked at from a scoring standpoint has been at the rim, but this is easy to counter if you can't shoot because the defense will sag and clog the lane. This is where a good mid-range game can come into play, especially when pushing the ball in transition. If you can stay on balance and get to your spot, these can be high percentage open looks for a point guard. Matt has developed the ability to break down his defenders off the dribble, creating space to get off his mid-range jumper. So whether he's using a ball screen or just working in an ISO situation, he's always looking for opportunities to get to his mid-range spots. Take note that when I say get to his spots, these are specific spots on the floor. The free throw line area is the highest percentage, but you should also look to get to the short corners. And in Matt's case, he's very good pulling up from just inside the wing area. He usually likes to use a combo move to get his defender on their heels, thinking he'll drive, so they usually back off, and that's when he pulls up. Once again, all of these shots require reps in order to be consistent, but mastering specific spots on the floor will increase your efficiency dramatically. Now that we've seen some of his pull-up game, we'll take it beyond the arc to see how he gets three-point opportunities. As you can see here, he's very comfortable playing off the ball, spacing the floor, and spotting up for catch-and-shoot threes. This allows his teammates to play on the ball while Matt spaces the floor. So on any penetration from Matt's teammates, the defense has to choose whether to give up an open three or allow the drive. Next, we'll look at his threes off the dribble, which is an extremely valuable skill in today's game. These situations come in a number of scenarios. The most frequent are coming off a ball screen, pulling up late in the shot clock, or pulling up in transition. No matter which scenario it is, Matt has proven that he can knock it down. And here's what's baffling. He shot an astounding 46% from three at Oak Hill, but he shot less than two threes per game. There are very few players who can knock it down at that rate, so I'd like to see him look to shoot it more. The result could be increasing his average from 12 points to 16 points per game, and adding that to his 8 assists and 5 rebounds, he'd be producing at a level that NBA scouts can't ignore. Last but definitely not least, let's look at Matt on the defensive end of the floor. We all know that Shaka Smart likes to put ball pressure on his opponents, so Matt will have to go right in and be a pest on the ball. The good news is that he's had experience playing this role for several years now. We already know he's got quickness, but he also has quick hands and can pluck opposing guards if they don't keep the ball protected. He's got a knack for getting steals, and a lot of it has to do with his IQ for the game. He's always lurking around the court, waiting for an opponent to make a mistake, and he knows how to capitalize on their mistakes. So anytime he's guarding the ball, he will be very disruptive to opposing guards while they try to get into their offense. Now we'll take a look at him guarding off the ball. The reason he's able to intercept so many passes is because he positions himself properly in a ball U-man line. He watches the eyes of the ball handler and then anticipates their passes when the time is right. But remember, this isn't something he does all the time. He averaged 2 steals per game, so when you go for steals, you better get them, because if you don't, your whole defense will be in a scramble to make up for your mistake. In Matt's case, he's able to see the game from a coach's point of view, so when he does decide to go for a steal, he usually comes up with it. It takes a lot of maturity to gamble like this, so knowing when to gamble is crucial. And funny as it may seem, Matt is a good shot blocker when defending other guards. He's got good timing, and he's been known to block a few shots here and there. So I think altogether, Shaka Smart will love the defensive skills he brings to Texas next year. So now we summarize. In just a few short years, Matt has gone from local star to 5-star, and now onto the Longhorns. It's been a pleasure to witness his love for the game throughout the years, and I hope that that can be a lesson for young players trying to reach this level. Matt worked his butt off to get here, but he never lost his love for the game. He's out there having fun each and every time he steps onto the floor. I think a lot of kids focus too much on the end goal instead of the process. You can't want to be good because of the accolades it brings in the end. You've got to love the game enough to enjoy the grind and enjoy the process of getting better over time. And if that's true, then my next breakdown might be about you. Thanks for checking out today's breakdown. Tune in next week for another episode of Film Room Fridays at 5 p.m. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you next week. Thank you.